Hey guys, this is Malinki. Welcome back to my channel, Voice of Malinki. Today we will talk about fluorescence in situ hybridization or FISH. And if you are new in my channel, please subscribe my channel. And if you like my video, please do like, comment and share my video. Okay, so first of all, what is FISH? Okay, so basically, FISH is a laboratory technique which uses fluorescent probes that bind to only particular parts of a DNA with a high degree of sequence complementarity. So here we have the target DNA. This DNA is present inside a cell. This is your target DNA. Because in this DNA, this is the red part. This is the part that you are interested. So this part is present in this target DNA. You want to check whether this part or this sequence is present in a particular cell. Therefore, you will make a probe. This is a probe. This is the oligonucleotide probe, single-stranded probe. This probe contains a sequence that is complementary to this sequence that is your interest. So you will apply this probe in the cell and this probe will attach to this part. So we can detect that thing, that this probe is attached with this part. This is called hybridization. And how we can detect? Because the probe is labeled with a fluorescent molecule. So if you check the result under the fluorescent microscope or confocal microscope, you can see a fluorescence that will come if this part, your target part, is present in the cell. And if this is absent in the cell, the probe will not bind with this part, so you will not see any fluorescence. And this FISH, it basically detects the presence or absence of specific DNA sequences on chromosome. Now, this fluorescent in situ hybridization or FISH, here it consists of three words. First is fluorescent, then it is in situ, and third is hybridization. So why this name? So fluorescent, because we use here a fluorescent probe, and in situ means we are placing this probe inside the cell. Whatever occurs inside a cell, we call them in situ. And hybridization, because the probe hybridizes with the target sequence of DNA. Clear? Next, working principle of FISH, or how FISH works. So FISH technique is performed in the following steps. And first here we have the cell. This is the cell. We can see this is the cell. So this is the nucleus of the cell. The first thing is we will fix the cell. We have to fix the cell. Fixation is the first step. Then the sample is heated. So we will heat the sample. So in the cell we have the target DNA that is present in the nucleus. Then we are heating the sample. So heat or heating mediates denaturation of DNA. That we know that DNA is made up of two strands, and after applying heat, denaturation of DNA will occur. These two strands are getting separated, right? Now this is denaturation of DNA. Now we will apply a specific probe. So here we are applying a specific probe. And the probe, it is an oligonucleotide sequence. You can say a little bit, it is like 20 nucleotide sequences. 20 nucleotide sequences is the probe. And that is attached to a fluorescent dye. So probe is attached to a fluorescent dye. So it is the dye. So it is specifically designed to bind its target. And next thing what we will do, the temperature is lowered. We will apply cooling. So temperature is lowered. Why? Because that enables the probe to attach the target DNA. Because we have heated the sample, so DNA denaturation occurred. Now, if you want to the hybridization process, then you have to lower the temperature so that the probe can hybridize with this target part. Right? Now, next step is washing. So several wash steps remove all unhybridized probes, because here we can see many probes are there which are unhybridized. They are excess in amount, so they did not hybridize with the target part. So we have to wash them. If you do not wash them, they will also give you a false signal, false fluorescence that you can see under the fluorescent microscope. So we have to wash them. And this is the result. So where a clean and clear hybridized target DNA probe is present. So that would be visualized using a microscope. So this is the principle of FISH. Now, types of probes. So there are different types of probes used in FISH technique. First is centromere probe. So these probes bind only centromere, only centromeric regions of chromosome. So this is used to count chromosome because they bind centromeres. So if you see them under microscope, you can count them. So number of fluorescence that are coming from different centromeres, it correspond to the chromosome numbers, right? Because one chromosome contains one centromere. So if you can see 15 fluorescence points are coming from 15 centromeres, that means 15 chromosomes are present. Next is telomere probe. So this probe binds only telomere or telomeric region of chromosome, that means the ends of chromosomes. Next is whole chromosome probe. So these probes basically bind to the whole length of chromosome and used to count the number of chromosomes, because they bind the whole chromosome. So again, you can count them and you can conclude that how many chromosomes are present in a particular cell. And this is also called whole chromosome painting, because you are painting the whole chromosome, because your probe is hybridized with the whole chromosome and your probe is giving you the fluorescence. So you can see that the whole chromosome is colorful. That is why it is called whole chromosome painting. And next is loca-specific probes. So these probes are specific to a particular region or locus of DNA. These are useful to detect deletion, duplication, or translocation mutation. Here, if a part of chromosome is deleted, we can see shorter chromosome under microscope compared to the wild type normal copy. Similarly, if duplication occurs, we could see the longer chromosome compared to its wild type normal copy. If translocation occurs, we can see the exchange of chromosomal parts between two chromosomes where translocation occurs, like that. Next, uses of FISH. So FISH is used to diagnose genetic syndromes, various infectious diseases and cancer. So FAST is to diagnose different genetic syndromes or to diagnosis of chromosomal abnormalities. So here I am providing you an example of Down syndrome. I hope you know that what occurs in Down syndrome. In Down syndrome, an extra copy of chromosome 21 is present. Extra copy of chromosome 21 is present. That means in Down syndrome, a cell contains 47 chromosomes and the 21 number of chromosome, you will get 3 copies of that instead of 2 copies. So suppose this is the normal cell and this is the Down syndrome cell. So here chromosome number 21, you will get only 2, and here we will get chromosome number 21, 3. So suppose I am using the probe that is binding the whole chromosome here. So here this is the probe, and here also this is the probe. And in this case, these three are the probes. So when we see them under microscope, from this you will get 2 fluorescence, whereas from this you will get 3 fluorescence signal. Like that, we can diagnose different chromosomal abnormalities, or you can say different genetic syndromes. Next is detection of infectious diseases. So here actually specific oligonucleotide probes are designed to detect pathogens in various infections. For example, FISH probes complementary to specific sequence of 16S rRNA. You are making a probe that is complementary to 16S rRNA. It can detect malaria infection in your blood samples. Why? Because 16S rRNA is basically a component of what? Component of prokaryotic ribosome 30S unit. So this is present only in prokaryotic ribosomes. In eukaryotic ribosomes, you will not get 16S rRNA. So this is the marker of that. This is the marker of any prokaryotic infection. So we can detect any infection occurs by bacteria or parasites by using this technique, where 16S rRNA is present and we are providing the probe that is complementary to its 16S rRNA. So hybridization will take place and it will fluoresce under microscope. So suppose this is the 16S rRNA. This is present in your body because you are infected by a parasite or you are infected by a bacteria. So here I am providing the probe here, and this probe will bind or hybridize with this. So hybridization will take place and it will fluoresce under microscope. That is one more thing, that the use of FISH. Next is, FISH is widely used to detect the chromosomal abnormalities that is associated with cancer. So for detection of cancer also, we can use FISH. It detects any type of chromosomal abnormalities associated with cancer. Here, HER2, HER2, HER2 positive breast cancer is the example. So basically, HER2 positive breast cancer has extra copies of HER2, HER2 gene, and FISH technique is performed on breast cancer tissue to detect the extra copies of the gene. Basically, this HER2, this is the HER2. So basically, this is a growth promoting, protein that is present outside of all breast cells. Now, when these genes are duplicated, duplication takes place, they produce excess amount of growth protein, growth promoting proteins, right? So they will produce excess amount of more amount of growth promoting proteins after duplication, right? That is very dangerous because that induces cancer to spread very fast because they are growth promoting proteins. Now we can make a probe against it, and that probe will bind to the complementary sequence, and if duplication takes place, then we can detect this after the fluorescence process because it will give you more fluorescence compared to the healthy cell. So that is one more use of FISH.